Jai Hind students, I am very happy to see your responses. I'm sharing few of your work and I hope you like my videos and will keep working hard. This is the last video of the chapter number 1, integers. Keep up the good work, students. Let's start with the last video of chapter number 1. Let's go through the properties of integers. These properties are important. So we are going to verify the properties for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, all the four operators. Now first property is closure. Closure meaning you take any two integers, okay, add them or subtract them or multiply them and check if the answer is an integer or not. If the answer is also an integer, then we say we have a closure property. Okay, we will check for this. For division, we don't have a closure property. Next, commutative property. Okay, associative and distributive. So let's go. We can say for addition, subtraction and multiplication, we have a closure property. They are close. For example, see 10, 2 and minus 2 are integers. Okay. Yes, we know they are integers. So now let's add them. 10 plus 2 is 12. Now 12 is also an integer. Let's subtract them. 10 minus 2 is 8. Yes. 8 is an integer. Yes or no? Yes, it is an integer. Okay. Let's say 2 minus 10. So minus 10, you know, 10 is greater. So answer will be minus 8. So this is minus 8. Minus 8 is an integer or not? Yes, it is an integer. Now let's check. 2 multiplied by 10. The product is 20. Now 20 is an integer. Yes or no? Yes, it is an integer. Now minus 10 multiplied by 2. Minus 20. Is it an integer? Yes, it is an integer. So we will say that, addition, subtraction and multiplication hold closure property. They are all closed. But let's say about division. Can we say the same for division? Let's check. 10 and 2, these two are integers. Yes or no? Yes, they are integers. Now let's divide. 10 divided by 2. What do you get? 5. Okay, is 5 an integer? Yes, 5 is an integer. Now let's interchange the values. So now let's see. 2 divided by 10. What you will get? The answer will be 1 upon 5 or it will be 0.2. Now 0.2 is not an integer. It is a decimal value. Similarly, 1 upon 5 is a fraction. They're not integers. So division does not hold closure property, because when we divide two integers, not necessarily, not always we are going to get integer. Okay, so division is not close. And division is not close, yes. Next, let's go with commutative property. Now, commutative property means that when you add two integers, the order will not change. For example, a plus b equal to b plus a, or if we talk about multiplication, then a multiplied by b will be b multiplied by a. For example, 4 plus 5 is 9, but you change the order. 5 plus 4, 5 plus 4 is also 9. Okay, so we say addition is commutative. Now let's check for multiplication. 2 multiplied by 3 is 6, and 3 multiplied by 2 is also 6. So the so we can say that commutative property holds for addition and multiplication, but the commutative property does not work for subtraction or division. Let's check. Okay, so commutative property does not hold for subtraction and division. How? Let's go through the examples. Now 8 minus 3 is 5, but if you interchange the order, if you change the order, so 3 minus 8 is not plus 5. It is minus 5. They are not equal. They are not same. So we cannot say that commutative properties hold that subtraction is the commutative property holds for subtraction. We cannot say that. Now let's check the division part. Now 8 divided by 4 is equal to 4 divided by 8. Now what is 8 divided by 4? It is 2. But 4 divided by 8 is half. 1 upon 2, right, which is a fraction. Again, 2 is not equal to, you know, these two values are not same. when you have changed the order. Therefore, we say the commutative property does not hold for subtraction and division. Now let's move to the associative property. Now see, when you add, okay, you can group the numbers in any combination. For example, just check a plus b plus c equal to a plus b plus c. Like they have changed the order. 2 plus, you can club 5 and 3 together, add them first, or you can club first two values together. Okay, there will be no change in the sum. In multiplication also, you can group the numbers in any combination, there will be no change. Now let's go through these examples. Now 3 plus 1 plus 5. So we club 3 plus 1 first. So it is 4 plus 5 equal to 9. And on the right side, I clubbed 1 plus 5 together. So it is 3 plus 6, which is 9. So we can see associative property holds for addition. Now check for multiplication. 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 2. Now we are grouping 5 and 4 together first, which is 5 multiplied by 4 is 20. 20 into 2 is 40. On the right side, 5 multiplied by 4 into 2. Now you are multiplying last 2 first. So 5 remains there, multiplied by 8 is again 40. You can see, does not matter in which order you multiply first or add first. Okay, so we say that associative property holds for addition and subtraction. Now, associative property does not hold for subtraction and division. Examples, just look these examples, go through these examples. Does 9 minus 5 minus 3, so there are 3 integers and we have changed their order. First, we are subtracting 9 minus 5, it is 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Then on the right side, 9 minus 5 minus 3, we are clubbing them first, okay, we are subtracting them. So 5 minus 3 is 2, 9 minus 2 is 7. So associative property does not hold for subtraction and division. You cannot change the order. Second, 8 divided by 4 divided by 2. So you divide first 2 first. So answer is 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. On the right side, you are taking last 2 first. 8 divided by 4 divided by 2, 8 divided by 2, it is 4. So, does not hold for subtraction and division. Now, let's check distributive property over addition. So, see 2 multiplied by 4 plus 3. Okay. So, this 2, we are going to multiply this 2, which is outside the bracket, with all the integers that are inside the bracket. So 2 goes with 4 also and 3 also. 2 multiplied by 4 is 8. 2 multiplied by 3 is 6. 8 plus 6, 40. Okay. Now let's check the example which is down there. 3 and then inside the brackets 10 plus 2. So 3 will be multiplied by 10 also and 2 also. Okay. Now distributive property also hold for subtraction. See, let's go through this example. 5 and in the bracket there is 6 minus 3. So this 5 we are going to multiply with 6 also and you are going to multiply with 3 also, and whatever sign is in the center you are going to keep it. 5 multiplied by 6 is 30. 5 multiplied by 3 is 15, and since in the bracket there was negative, so you'll keep that sign. 30 minus 15 equal to 50. Now, distributive property does not hold for division and multiplication. You can clearly see this. 16 divided by, in the bracket, this is 8 plus 2. You can't do this. Okay. See, you cannot divide 16 by 8 also and 2 also and then sum. Take out the sum. No, this is not right. So, distributive property does not hold for division and multiplication. Now, students, I've told you about additive identity property. What was additive identity? That when 0 is added to any number, the sum is the original number. Okay. So 0 is the identity element of addition. See, 13 plus 0, you get 13. Minus 7 plus 0, you get minus 7. You get the same number. So similarly, is a multiplicative identity. What do you multiply with any number so that you get the same number? For example, I say 3. What do you multiply by 3 so that you get 3? answer is 1. What do you multiply by 100 to get 100? You multiply 1. So when any number is multiplied by 1, the product is the original number. Therefore, we say 1 is the identity element of multiplication.
Okay? Now we are done with the chapter. Thank you.